Hello everybody, it's Xander with a new video and this is gonna be a tough one. So, as the new Marvel's Eternals movie is out, we can see a bunch of cool visual effects, and one of them is what Superman calls heat vision, these laser beams coming out of their eyes. So, I'm gonna show you how I recreated that. Now, this is gonna be an intermediate tutorial, so you need to have basic knowledge of After Effects and Mocha Pro for the tracking. I think that's all you need to know, so let's jump into it. Now bring your footage into After Effects, drop it into a new comp, then right click and create a null layer, rename it to right eye, duplicate and rename for the left eye. Now right click on your footage, pre-compose and check move all attributes into the new composition. Next, select it and go to Effects, Mocha Pro. If you don't have the Pro version, you could use the free Mocha AE version, but it doesn't include the mesh warp tracker, which we'll be using for the skin tracking. Now use the X-spline tool to draw an area for the skin around the right eye, and you don't need to do it for the left eye as the laser beam will be covering it. Now come over to the track panel, check mesh, change the generation mode to uniform and decrease the mesh size a bit, and now click on generate mesh. If it is your first time using Mocha Pro, you can click on this card and watch my previous tutorial about all the details. Next, we're gonna draw a new shape for each eye and rename each one to match. Drag forward and when it reaches the end, as I close my eyes, you will get this message. So now, disable the eye layers and continue tracking for the mesh. Then go back to the start point, re-enable them and track backwards. And do the same thing when the eye is shut. Now, with the mesh layer selected, click on the show planar surface to stabilize it on the frame we started at. Then expand to make it fill the entire frame. Go to the stabilize panel, check mesh warp box and change it from draft to high. Close and save Mocha. And now in the tracking data, click on create track data. Select one of the tracks, change the export to transform and select the corresponding null layer to apply to it. Then do the same thing for the second eye and null layer. Now the first thing we will make is the bright eye effect. So create a new solid layer and draw a mask around the iris of one of the eyes. Then draw another mask for the full eye and set this one to intersect so it only shows the selection of the first mask within the second mask. Feather both masks a bit, then link it to the eye track and enable motion blur. Now add a fractal noise effect, change the blending mode to none to get rid of this outline. Increase the brightness and contrast, then alt click the evolution stopwatch and type in the following time expression. Time *200 for it to slowly animate throughout the clip. And now decrease the scale to add more detail to it and then add a glow effect, set it to screen and increase the radius. To add the orangey color, I will be using Video Copilot Color Vibrance plugin. Change the color to orange, increase the gamma and check fill MTBG. Set the layer to screen, then duplicate the glow effect, drop it under the color, and change some of the settings like so. Duplicate it again and change the settings to add a softer final glow. And you can always use the fractal noise brightness to control how hot you want the eyes to look. Now, I'm gonna keyframe the mask for when I open and close my eyes, then trim the layer to start and end at these points. Duplicate this layer and move it to the other eye, parent it to the other null layer, and of course change the mask to fit the shape of this eye. Change the evolution random seed to change the pattern to make it different than the first eye. And now we have this. Now we'll create that skin vein texture, and for this I'm gonna be using this free water texture that I got from nsplash.com. Place it on top, scale it down and set it to screen. Now add a tint effect to make it black and white, then add a curves effect to add more brightness and contrast to it. And you can copy the fractal noise from one of the eye layers and change the blending mode to multiply, adjust the scale brightness and contrast settings, and then duplicate it, play with the settings again, just to add more patterns across the texture. Create a new solid layer for the matte, then change the texture track matte to alpha and draw a shape on the solid around the right eye and feather it out a bunch. And because this is a matte, you can easily reposition it to find the pattern you like. And if I move the anchor point to the middle, I can rotate and scale it around the eye. For more detail, you can duplicate both layers and scale both down. You can also add the shape layer and draw in some curves to get that veiny look. And here you can change the stroke color and width for the lines. Change the blending mode to overlay, then copy and paste one of the fractal noise effects again and add a fast box blur effect. Now select all of those layers, right click and pre-compose for the skin texture. set the blending mode to screen, and copy-paste the mocha effect from our main clip. In the model renders, change the model to stabilize warp and warp quality to high. And now, this is what you get. Copy the color and glow effects from the eye into it, and adjust the settings to your liking. And then add a fast box blur effect and keyframe the blur amount along with the layer opacity to blur and fade at the start and at the end of the effect. So it looks something like this. For the final step, which is the beam, I will be creating a new solid layer and make it bigger than my main comp so it always remains in frame even after linking into the track. And for this, I will be using the free Saber plugin from Video Copilot. You will find the link to it in the description. Now change this layer to screen, link it to the right eye track, and position the core start and end points to line up with your footage. Now change the preset to fire to get that distorted look, and change the color to be a bit yellowy. And change the glow intensity, decrease core start, and increase end size. Then, decrease the glow distortion amount and increase the noise scale, and do the same thing for the core distortion amount and noise scale. Then, increase both wind speed and noise speed and lower the motion blur to see more details. Now keyframe the end offset at the beginning to show the laser beam extending, like so. And at the end, keyframe the start offset and start size to have it finish this way. And then, trim the layer at this point. Now, to get these spark lines, I will duplicate the beam layer and change the Saber preset to tractor beam. Again, change the color, glow settings and distortion settings to speed them up and then uncheck blend on top. And lower the vertical scale of the solid to keep it closer to the main beam. I'm gonna add a directional blur to smoothen it out, and then add a vector blur to make it a bit thinner. And lastly, add an exposure effect to boost its visibility, and we have this. Now create a new adjustment layer to draw a few masks around the face and the areas that should be lit. Feather them out and add a curves effect, increase the brightness and the red color, and lower the blue color to have that orange light reaction. Now keyframe the opacity at the start and at the end. I'm also going to use Video Copilot's Heat Distortion plugin. This is an option. If you don't have it, it's fine. So, draw a mask for the beam to add some displacement, and finally, you can add some overall glow, like so, some cool bokeh flares like this one from VFX Central, and then just color grade your footage. And add some sound effects to get something like this.
That's it for today, guys. I hope you liked today's tutorial. If you do, push the thumbs up button, and of course, don't forget to subscribe for more videos, and see you in the next one.